Okay, so about 3 days ago, Google launched a brand new feature called Gemini Storybook, and I think it can be pretty effective for language learning. Basically, it allows you to create personalized illustrated stories about anything with read aloud narration. And if you scroll down, you can see that it's available in over 45 different languages. I basically learned about this feature from watching this video over here where this person made a story about a robot in Japanese, and I was like, hey, I can use this for my own Japanese studies. So what I did is I went to Google's Gemini, like gemini.google.com, and then I said, write a story in Japanese about the Meiji Restoration to help me learn new words. And then clicking open over here, this is what it generated. So I can flick through it, and I can also press listen to actually listen to the story. And then I can skip ahead, and I can see that it has more images, and it has character consistency, and it's actually like a full story. And if you have a browser extension installed like Yomitan here, then you can also use that. So I don't know what this word means over here, and I can hover over the word, press shift, and then I can see scrolling down, it's a top knot hairstyle worn by men in the Edo era. And if you have a link to Anki, then you can also press this add button and then it adds it to your Anki as well. Or if I don't know what this word means over here, I can hover over it and it says it's a steam locomotive. And then I told it to redo the story, but at a level that a 5-year-old would understand. And then going through the story over here, it's much simpler. It doesn't use as long sentences. Its writing system is not as complicated because it doesn't use any kanji, which is the more complicated system, the writing system in Japanese. And yeah, overall, it's like a shorter story, but it's very comprehensible. And then I said in another chat, create a storybook of a UFO invasion in Japanese, right at the level of a 7-year-old. And going through the storybook, like I can listen to it as well. I can choose between a lower pitched voice and a high pitched voice over here as I'm listening for it. And I also learned a few words space-related when going through the storybook. I also tried with a 10-year-old level, so I said, create a storybook of the Satsuma clan and their first trip overseas to learn about Western technologies, and I created the storybook over here. And it's more complicated as well because it's the level of a 10-year-old, and I learned more words going through this as well. And I also said, do it at the level of a 15-year-old. And it didn't really do it like that complicated. I think it kind of cuts out at the level of a 12 or 13-year-old. I'm pretty sure a 15-year-old would have a really easy time reading this. And I can also do another one in Chinese by saying, write a storybook about the British taking over Hong Kong in Chinese at the level of a 5-year-old. I don't know any Chinese, so I don't know how good this will turn out, but for Japanese, it did turn out pretty well. And this usually takes about 3 to 5 minutes to complete. And as we're waiting for that to complete, I'll talk about why I like this. The biggest reason is that you can listen to a story as you're looking at the photos. So when you are starting out with learning a language, it's much more important to improve your listening and speaking skills than it is to improve your reading and writing skills. It helps to do a bit of reading and writing maybe, but mostly like you should be doing speaking and listening like 95% of the time. So I can be listening to a story and just looking at the photo, not the text, and then when I hear a brand new word, if I don't immediately know what it means by looking at the picture, I can just look it up over here. So for example, this word, I knew that immediately meant that it was made of stone because like looking at the photo, it's pretty obvious that all these buildings are made of stone over here. And I think the other benefit is that when you're learning a language, you want to make sure you're using engaging material that you personally find interesting. And I really like Japanese history, so when I'm learning Japanese, it's pretty nice I can just learn about Japanese history from this like AI-generated storybook that's read out loud to me. So I actually learned about the Satsuma clan and their first trip overseas about to learn about Western technologies when I was in a museum in Kagoshima, and then I wanted to know more about this, and this is like a pretty nice way of knowing more about this. But of course the level that you choose, whether that's a 5-year-old, 7-year-old, or 10-year-old, or something else, does depend on how good you are at the language already. If you don't know any words, or you know like 10 words, it's probably better that you find another way to learn more words. And then after you know a couple hundred words, you can start doing the level of a 5-year-old, for example. For me, I know several thousand words, so I can do like the level of a 10-year-old pretty easily, but I haven't reached like the level of a 15 or 16-year-old right now. So I finished generating the storybook in Chinese, so we can press the listen over here.
在很久很久以前, 大海边有一个安静的小渔村.
And yeah, in this case, I don't understand anything because I don't know any Chinese, but looking at the photos, it's quite good because it's like character consistent. It's actually telling a story, you can kind of figure out what some words mean, and so forth. So if you do try this, then leave a comment down below with what you think, and I think it is pretty promising, because sooner or later in the future, you will be able to make your own TV shows, or own video games, or just anything to help you learn a language. Because one of the best ways of actually learning a language is to just consume a lot of content within that language. Whether that's just television shows, movies, media, or just anything else, consuming a lot of content is like pretty good overall. But if you can have content made just at your level for something that you're interested in, then I think that can be pretty powerful. And I hope that in the future you can sooner or later generate like a 20-minute long episode or entire TV show that's really interesting to you. That's in another language that can help you learn more words. And if you are interested in more things related to AI when it comes to language learning, then do subscribe because I will be making more videos like this as it happens.